Here you can see a pcap file open in Wireshark and it's collected network traffic. We want to find the net NTLM v2 hashes and we extract them from the pcap so we can crack them with Hashcat. The way to start is you search for NTLM SSP up here in the filter box in Wireshark, and that filters it down to all the NTLM negotiations or NTLM protocol messages. So in this case, we have an SMB connection that was captured. And the way to read this is we have the client initiates the attempt or the intent. You know, I want to talk with the server. The server sends back a challenge. This is this NTLM SSP underscore challenge. And then the client sends the response or then the actual authentication request. So what we do now is we need to extract a couple of fields, and I prepared them over here in this little text file. So we need the username, the domain name, the challenge, the HMAC of the NTLM v2 response, and the NTLM v2 response. These are the fields that Hashcat requires in order to crack a password. Let's find and extract them from the network capture. The way to do this, we start out here in a second, so when the server responds to the negotiation request from the client. So let me go up here. So you need to find the server message block in this case, but what is more important, because the NTLM authentication is encapsulated in this SMB protocol, what you're really looking for is the NTLM service provider. So there's a security blob, and you're going to find NTLM service provider here. And if you scroll down, you will find NTLM server challenge. So right click, you copy that. Let's put it in for now. Let's just put it in here. So this is the challenge. The next field is in the actual authentication request from the client. So we click on that item up here, go to the security blob, find TLM security provider again. Here we have that. Then you see the NTLM response from the client. And here we have now this. This is actually the most important field, NTLM v2 response. Right click, copy, copy value, and put that in here for response now. But there's a little bit of a trick to make it very quick for you to actually get the HMAC value, which in Wireshark, this value HMAC is also called NT proof string. So it's literally the next string here. So you could just copy that one, or another faster ways, it's the first 16 bytes is going to be, so when you just go here, you can just take the first 16 bytes, cut it and copy it up over here. So we now have these. Now we need the user and the domain. Those we find if we keep scrolling down. So domain name, lowercase area 51, username Alice. So you could just, I guess we can just copy just to show how that works again, but I think it's simple enough. And this was Alice. So now we have all the fields required for Hashcat. And in order to put it in the Hashcat format, so I created another file here. I'm just going to copy paste this over here. And now we are just going to remove these values that we don't need. So it's going to be the username, a double double. This is very important. Two colons first. Then it's going to be the challenge. That is just separated by a colon in the format. Then we're going to have the next field is, again, always separated with a colon. And we're going to append the proof string or the HMAC. And the last item is going to be the actual NTLM v2 response. Let's remove those. So now we have like this long string. And you can save that. And this is now a valid Hashcat hash, like it's in the format that Hashcat can actually start cracking it. And to show you how this works, like if you've used Hashcat before, you can do Hashcat help, and you could actually also, just to see that you find the right word, you search for NTLM in the, because it has all these options for cracking. This is the one we want, the mode 5600. So we can do Hashcat. We're going to run the mode 5600, and we're going to do it on the SMB hash.txt file that we have. And I have a word list prepared just called words, and hit return. It's going to go off, and it successfully, you can see here, successfully recovered. It went so fast that we couldn't even see, but here you see Alice, the hash, and this is the password. I hope this was interesting and fun to watch. And if you like the content, subscribe, click the like button, and I'll see you next time. Have a good one.